Benvenuti, we are just back from the beach. We went to Happisburgh.
No, Happisburgh.
But is Happisburgh the way I pronounce it?
That's how it's spelled, but it's called in Norfolk, Happisburgh.
Yeah, well, that doesn't make any sense because I think of happy days, I remove the days, and then I think of Middlesbrough, I remove the middle, so not happy, no middle, Happisburgh.
Wow, just wow.
That's how I get by in this country, remembering weird names because they change the language. Why? Anyhow, we went to the beach and the idea was that we would have a light tea and no video today, but as I was laying down in the sun, I was thinking to make a frittata, and I wasn't going to video because I've made a few frittatas and clearly I'm trying to limit, avoid replicating. But then as I was kind of semi-sleep, I thought of a recipe and I thought, okay, I can try this and see what it looks like. So I'm making a frittata, but if you have ever made a toad in the hole, the majority is butter and then there is sausages. This time is going to be slightly different. It's the other way around, where I'm going to put a little flour, but mostly eggs, and I'm experimenting something new. So let's see how it goes. So the first thing as I walked into the house was to defrost a few sausages. And these are nice, juicy, big sausages. They've got no filling rather than pork, really. So nothing special, but we like them because they are bigger than the average sausage. So they are still partly, only slightly frozen, and I've done that on purpose so that they are easier to cut in half. So literally, I'm gonna go along with my knife and chop them in half. I wonder actually if a steak knife might be even easier. Nope, no. Back to plan A. I'm making a fairly big batch, by the way. Whenever I make frittata, I have, or we have, some on the day, but then we have the rest cold for lunch or snack the following few days. I get hold of my favorite cast iron frittata pan, and I'll go along and position my sausages with the skin side facing downwards. And of course, everything is cold at the moment. My oven is on at 180 degrees. I'll pop them in for 15, 20 minutes, enough for them to cook. Done. In the meantime, I'll get on with the other ingredients. This is plain flour, and I will be using 8 eggs today, and I've been very strict and measuring exactly 1 level tablespoon of plain flour per egg, and 8. Imagine you're making Yorkshire pudding, but much reduced quantities of flour, followed by 1 level teaspoon of salt and some pepper. And I've moved on to the eggs now. I'm adding them to my flour. So 5, 6, and 8. And I'm mixing everything together until I get a nice and liquidy batter, but also all of the flour has effectively disappeared. This is parsley and this is rosemary, which I've just picked from the garden. And I'm going to be mixing them together and I'll give them a good chop. The reason why I've chosen parsley is because it's an all-round herb which goes well with most things, but rosemary goes really, really well with pork, so the combination would be ideal for this dish. But of course, you can choose whatever you like. This is my choice today. And I'll pick them up and add them to the egg batter. These are vegetables fresh from Julie's garden, and this is a little bit more than this. It's what I would have used before I closed my eyes and start fantasizing about the sausages. And what we have here is some chard, a few spinach, and a little kale.
Just this is all there is left of the kale. The caterpillars have eaten it all now.
Well, they go to eat as well.
Yeah.
So I'll chop them in rough pieces, nothing too fancy. Red onion, medium size. Remove the skin, and I'll chop this in rings like this. The reason why I'm doing this is because they will come apart when I cook them, and they'll be quite nice to look at. And I'm gonna be using also a clove of garlic. As it is, I'll crush it with the skin on and add it to the rest of my vegetables. New frying pan, olive oil, and I'm throwing everything inside now. hobbies on maximum number 9. As soon as they start sizzling and making lots of noises, I'll turn them down on number 4, so medium low, and I'll let them cook for maybe 7-8 minutes until the onions have cooked and the vegetables have shrunk in volume. So my vegetables are cooked and they've been resting now for 5 minutes, cooling down. Also, I have grated some cheddar cheese, which I'm going to add to my egg mix, followed by my vegetables. And I'm going to use the wooden spoon to mix this together because I find that the whisk gets all tangled up and everything gets in there, and it's quite annoying actually.
Do you, dear?
I do, yes. And the sausages are done as well. They're making that lovely noise that sausages do. I'm giving them a very quick shake to ensure that they're not stuck to the bottom of the pan, but they're pretty good actually, they're moving nicely. And I will not be adding any oil to these because quite clearly there is plenty of fat that has been released from the sausages. However, the one thing I'll do, because the sides also need to be greased, using a brush I'll go along and on the edges and make sure that there is some fat in there as well. I'm trying to flatten them, but they won't. They go a man of their own.
They'll be fine.
Okay. I'm ensuring that the surface is pretty much covered by sausages. And now is when I'll pour in my mix. If you haven't got one already, I highly recommend that you invest in a spatula. They are brilliant.
We have a selection of about 8 in this house. I've got a bit of a fetish for spatulas.
And this is beginning to look scrumptious already. Look at the colour that is coming through with the green. I was going to add some tomatoes on top to garnish, but it looks so lovely, we decided against it. I've actually halved some. We'll make a salad with these instead. But one thing I'll do, I'll pop it in the oven for 20 minutes at 200 degrees. Mine is a fan-assisted oven. If yours is a normal oven, you can... Sorry, the other way around, actually, isn't it? 180 degrees, fan-assisted. If yours is a normal oven, 200. And about for 15 minutes normal. And then for the last 5 minutes, I'll take it out anyway. I will be adding some cheddar cheese on the top, but I'll show you that later. And off it goes. Job done. While it cooks, I just wanted to say something about the beach. And here is a photo of me this morning when my hat flew off. And it's very strange because I grew up near the seaside, and when I was a young lad, from the age of 1 was probably, for the summer months we used to move to the seaside, and I didn't go anywhere until actually I met Julie, funnily enough, and that's all I knew really. And as a child, up until the age of 5-6, I was really, really shielded. And the funny thing is that to me, that was normal to have 3 months on the beach, and then that was the world as I saw it. Nowadays, children are born with a mobile phone, and by the age of 5 or 6, they know everything, of course, but I didn't. And the strange thing is that even today, when I go to the beach, and I see people, families arriving to the beach with a car, I think it's strange because they have a day or two, most probably throughout the summer. And I forget how lucky I was to spend 3 times of my life as a child on the beach. And it's a strange sensation still. I thought I'd share that with you because it is interesting how children, depending on where they are in the world, of course, experience life differently. And mine was wonderful from that point of view. And bang on, 15 minutes, and it's ready for the cheese. This is very optional, by the way. You don't have to add cheese if you don't want to, but we think that...
Why would you not want to add cheese?
Well, you know, you might not like cheese. And I've stuck with cheddar, by the way, rather than using Parmesan, because I think it's going to melt better, and it's very flavourful anyway.
Mm. It needs a little something.
Julie says I missed a bit.
Yeah, I missed a bit.
There you go. 5 more minutes and it will be ready. Voila. Perfetto. It has actually been resting now for about 7 minutes, and it should be easier because there is flour in there, and just like when you're making Yorkshire puddings, you will find that they come out easily. Not always, but more often than not. So I'm going to turn this and have a quick look to see. Yeah, it's quite easy to put my spatula in between my frittata and my pan. The only thing I need to establish is if it's stuck to the bottom. So I'm going to put this spatula underneath to see if I can dislodge it. Yeah, and there it is, it's moving. So it looks like the trick has worked. And I'm going to move it into a plate. And this is as clean as a whistle.
Besides, do I just smell a bit like a toad in the hole?
Yeah, the sausages. Talking of which, what shall we call this? We haven't thought about that. It's not a toad in the hole. It's not a frittata. It's not a Yorkshire pudding. How about frittata in the hole, Julie?
Why not?
What does it sound like to you?
Why not?
There you go, we've invented a new dish, frittata in the hole. It feels nice and compact as I go with the knife, which is promising. And because of the flour, by the way, you should not need any bread with this. But I did say that I was going to make a little salad with my leftover tomatoes. So here, this is what I have put together. There are leaves of basil and mint, olive oil, some olives, and mozzarella, and I put a sprinkle of oregano on the mozzarella and a few olives. Very, very easy and refreshing. And here is my multi-purpose cake slice frittata server. Let's have a look. Ooh, that's exciting.
Yum. Yeah, it's good. Looking forward to this. I love toad in the hole.
Hey?
I said I'm looking forward to this. I love toad in the hole.
It's nice and solid, as I said before, and actually it's got a very, very pleasant consistency. It's still hot, but you can eat this cold the day after, the day after, the day after. It will last for 3 days maybe in the fridge. I think I'll go to the beach more often before I lay down. It's wonderful. It's really delicious. You don't need any bread because of the flour. I think I say that. And so it's an all-in-one meal, and it's really delicious. I'm actually looking forward to tomorrow as well, when I can try that cold. Give it a shot. You will love it. If you like toad in the hole, if you like frittata, and if you like Yorkshire puddings, you will love this. Ciao, ciao. Thank you for watching. Bye.